Hello everyone, now I will show you how to set up your LINKSYS router. And before I start, I want to remind you that if my video will help you, please support my work. Half of all donations I send to animal shelters. All details are in the description down below. So, first thing you need to do is turn on the router. Take the power adapter. Plug one end into an outlet. And the other into the router. Then press the power button. When the router is powered on, the light will turn on. It may take a few minutes for it to completely turn on. Next, connect the cable from your broadband provider or from your modem to a special internet port. This port usually has a different color and labeled as WAN. Each cable should be inserted until it clicks. Now you need to reset the router to the factory settings. Press and hold the reset button on the router for 10 seconds, until the indicator lights on the router begin to flash. Sometimes this button is located inside the router casing to avoid accidental pressing. In this case, use a thin object to press on it. The router will reboot and the settings will return to the factory defaults. Insert one end of the Ethernet cable that comes with the router into one of the Ethernet ports. ND the other into your computer's Ethernet port. Please wait a few minutes for connection. The router is now connected to your computer. Now you need to set it up. But first, I will show you another method for connecting the router if you do not have an Ethernet cable or your computer does not have an Ethernet port. Connect the router to the power adapter and your internet provider's cable. This will enable Wi-Fi. If the router is new and has never been configured, the Wi-Fi network will have the name of your router. Your router has its own Wi-Fi network name and password printed on a sticker. Connect to it. Great, you've connected to the router. Now let's start setting it up. First, open your web browser and visit the URL you see on the screen. Use the URL bar instead of the search bar. First, on this page, click on this label. Or if it's not there, tap on the phone picture. On the next page, you can choose the language for the router's admin panel. In the router password field, enter the default password, admin. If this password doesn't work, you'll need to reset it to factory default. To do this, click on Reset Password. Then enter the recovery key from your router to reset the password. Look for a sticker with this key on your router. This sticker is usually located on the bottom side of the router. Type the recovery key into the field. Then click the Submit button. Next, you'll need to create a new password and a password hint. Pay attention to the password requirements. Then click the Reset button. On the next page, enter your new password. If your router settings do not look like mine, it means that your router has a different firmware. I made a video for every firmware type. You can find all the links in the description down below. I want to warn you right away that there are many firmware versions and they may differ slightly. But don't worry, you will succeed. Just watch the video and follow the instructions. Now go to the Connectivity tab. Then open the Internet Settings tab. Click Edit. And choose your internet connection type. You can find this information in the contract with your internet provider. If you're not sure which connection type you have, just select this one. It's the most common option. Click the Apply button. Next, go to the Wi-Fi Settings tab. Here you can change the name and password of your Wi-Fi network. If your router can support multiple bands, then click on Show More to set up separate names and passwords for different bands. Then click the Apply button. Double-check that the information is correct, then click Yes. Wait a couple of minutes for the settings to update. Then reconnect to the Wi-Fi network using the new credentials. Now check if your internet is working. Just Google something. If the internet does not appear, try cloning your MAC address. To do this, go to the Connectivity tab. Then to the Internet Settings tab. Check the box next to MAC address clone. Click the Apply button. Now you need to restart your router. To do this, go to the Troubleshooting tab. Then to the Diagnostics tab. And click Restart. After a couple of minutes, when the router is fully powered on, check again to see if the internet is available. Just try Googling something. If internet still doesn't appear, contact your internet service provider. He will tell you what type of connection you have and what other settings you need to do. That's all. If my video was useful, please support my work. I send half of all donations to animal shelters. All the details are in the description below.